Boston. You men head south. We'll take the stagecoach tram.
Where does it hurt most?
My ankle. Here and here.
Busted rib. Somebody put the boot to you, huh?
Horse fell on me.
Take it easy a minute. Sit up. Let's roll up your shirt. Raise your hands over your head. Feel better?
Much, thanks.
Let's get out of here. Well, why don't you say what you're thinking?
I'm not thinking anything.
Take a chew of this. It'll help you keep your mind off the pain.
Thanks.
Come on. Me a Santa Claus.
What's that?
Nothing, nothing at all. This is a stage depot. They'll take care of you. I'll still need your horse.
You're welcome to it and anything else I have.
Forget it.
What's going on here?
Like one of them, does he?
I never seen this fella before.
What do you want?
What's your name, stranger?
Edward Creighton.
What you doing here?
Surveyor.
Surveyor?
Yes, I work for Western Union.
What's Western Union?
Well, telegraph company. We're going through here next year on our way to the coast.
I guess he's all right.
Anything wrong?
We had a bank hold up at North Platte today. We killed one of them. The rest of them scattered. Looks like we've lost them now for good.
She's here, Mr. Creighton.
Oh, good.
Are you ready?
I think so, Bert. Now, if I can just manage to navigate on these things, Bert.
I reckon you'll be back this way with that telegraph line for long.
If everything goes right, I will.
I do a little trapping now and then, so I was wondering how much it would cost to send my pelts into Omaha by telegraph.
You can't send pelts by telegraph, Bert.
You can't?
No. All you can send is writing.
Then the telegraph ain't gonna do me any good.
Bert, you know, I can't repay you for your kindness, but, well, this may help a little.
Thanks. folded money.
Can you manage all those things yourself?
Oh, yes, sir. Better let me take that, too.
Woody. Woody, I want you to have this along with my thanks.
Gosh, Mr. Creighton, thanks.
Goodbye, boys. I'll see you next year.
Nice fella.
Yes, sirree.
But you don't believe what he said about that there telegraph coming through here, do you?
Of course not. There ain't no such thing as a telegraph, nohow. But he's a right nice fella just the same.
He sure is. Look what he gave me, his watch and chain.
Yes. Now, what is a fella that goes to bed at sundown and gets up at sunup want with a watch?
Well, it's a mighty pretty thing to wear. Sounds nice, too.
Yes.
For drivers, diggers, pole men, and timber cutters is $2 a day. And when we hit the Indian country, it's $3. And every man supplies his own gun. Okay?
What do you mean, okay?
It's telegraph talk. Means all right. Now, if the doc here passes you, why, you buckos have got yourself a job.
You know, Darryl? Stand up, son. Nice blizzard.
I ain't no horse.
You wish your work for you through. Yeah, feels like you got a slug of lead there, partner. 44?
Engineer ahead. It don't bother me none.
You know, some members of the medical profession like to cut them things off, but I say let them stay if they're set comfortable. You know this country we're going into?
100 miles from here. I lost this hair back in 56.
Need better surgery, right?
Oh.
What's ailing you?
Did he say 100 miles from here?
Oh, that was 5 years ago. Nowadays, we don't see no engines this side of Cottonwood Springs. Then you and me start drawing down an extra dollar, eh?
Speak for yourself, stranger. When I get back to St. Joe, I figure on keeping my hair instead of telling the folks how I lost it.
Indians don't always scalp a fella.
Not if the fella scalps them first.
This ain't for me. I've got to have peace and quiet when I'm preparing my victuals.
Are you a cook?
For 20 years, with the same head of hair. And I intend to be for 20 more. Gents, I bid you a good day.
Hold him, Doc.
Oh, no, Dr. Murdoch.
Yeah?
Mr. Creighton says he don't need these no more.
Put them down. Go down to the cookhouse and tell that good-for-nothing poisoner he's fired.
Can you cook lamb?
There are 9 different ways to cook mutton, and I know them all. Boiled, stewed, fricasseed.
Never mind that. Do you cook it with the hair on it?
I should say not.
Hooray!
Then you're hired.
No, no.
And your job is see that he stays hired.
That remind me sometime to show you an old Indian way to cook prairie dog.
Oh, no, I should have stayed in St. Joe.
Hello, Mr. Creighton.
Oh, hello, Bert. Well, where's Miss Creighton, Pat?
Oh, she's over at the corral, sir. We're buying some new horses today.
Oh.
How many have you?
sat with my sister, Pat.
That's the fella I hired to do our scoffing and take charge of the livestock, sir.
Hello, Sue.
Edward, darling!
Don't tell me you've given up telegraphy for a corral.
Oh, Edward, I'm so glad you're back. What did Dr. Washington say?
Well, he says I'm fit as a fiddle. I could walk from here to Salt Lake on my hands if I had to.
I'm so glad.
Sure, this is Mr. Creighton, the big boss. The only man around here you have to be polite to.
Glad to know you, Shaw. You've got to take a lot of horses and cattle a long way. Do you think you can manage it?
I think so.
Good. Come on, sis. You're supposed to be a telegrapher, you know.
Goodbye, Mr. Shaw.
Goodbye, ma'am.
What's the rush, Shaw? We're not leaving here for a couple of days.